Hard to believe, but we're here. Final contest on semifinal Thursday here at the Emory Folmar YMCA Soccer Complex, Montgomery Soccer Stadium, field number 2, where we've got a pretty good matchup for our primetime showdown. It's the second-seeded Bethel Wildcats taking on the third seed on Auburn Montgomery Warhawks. Alongside Hunter Lee, Wade Neely, glad to be with you. If you just joined us, thrilling contest in our first men's semifinal of the day, as fourth-seeded Martin Methodist is able to for a 1-1 draw against top seed Mobile. They advance via the penalty kick shootout. Goalkeeper Stephen Lunny had 2 big saves in the shootout for Martin Methodist. Going to be a fantastic contest in our finale here this evening. A lot of folks in the pre-tournament prediction saying this would probably be the top contest of the tournament. Bethel and Auburn Montgomery, both teams with a chance. We mentioned they're number 2 and number 3, but both teams had a chance on the final match day of the regular season to claim the conference championship. So this should be a pretty entertaining contest. Hunter Lee, you and I have seen both of these teams in action. We've seen AUM quite a bit over the years as Bethel. It's going to be fun to watch these two teams go at each other. They both play very frenetic-paced, high-energy-type soccer here, and where should they be in store for a good one tonight?
Yeah, it's definitely going to be an entertaining matchup here, especially if you take into account their 2-2 draw back on October 2nd. And that was the lone draw on the AUM schedule. So AUM likely to look here to get a win for the first time against this Bethel team this season. And Bethel likely looking to do the same, especially as the 2 seed in this conference tournament.
Number 5, Benjamin Sweet. Number 7, Errol Reed. Number 8.
Starting lineups being introduced. We'll begin with the Bethel University Wildcats. They are coached by Melvin Belong.
Number 11, Vincius
Mark Weir, Linsworth Daly, Benjamin Sweet, Errol Reed, Tevin Sykers, Samuel Goney, Keba Dimba, Vinicius Kirchner, Olusin Olarian, David Orr, and Gilmar Goncalves round out the 11 for the Bethel Wildcats. Meanwhile, the 11 for Auburn Montgomery being introduced. Philip Hitpass, he was a first-team all-conference selection at the awards banquet last night. He gets the start in net. Krish Patel, Nicholas Huno, Baron Watson, Dominique Budic, Sebastian Latico, Daniel Grobini, Yannick Falik, and golfer Anderson, Franco Varga, and Lucas Messenger get the startup and the starting lineup, I should say, for Auburn Montgomery. We apologize for any errors this evening, as this is our fourth contest. We're running low on caffeine, but we're refueling here as Wolf Koch being introduced, the head coach of the Auburn Montgomery Warhawks. Winner of this game, we mentioned earlier, we'll meet Martin Methodist in the championship round on Saturday. Auburn Montgomery very likely to still be included in the NAIA tournament field regardless of tonight's result. Bethel, meanwhile, probably a win would certainly solidify their resume with the MRPI coming out next week. But both teams want to just take care of business on the field here in Montgomery tonight, and that's what makes this contest and this matchup so appealing in semifinal number 2. So both teams getting set. We'll have our kickoff coming up in just a moment. You are watching Southern States Athletic Conference Championship men's soccer action here on the SSAC Sports Network. 42 degrees the temperature as we are set to kick things off. Scheduled for 7 o'clock. A couple of shootouts. I've got us just a touch tardy here today. Forgive our tardiness, but we've got a good one in our nightcap tonight. 7:24 will be our kickoff time. And we are underway here in Montgomery. It'll be the Warhawks and the Bethel Wildcats. Bethel in those home white unis. Again, they were the second seed. They claimed that title on the last match day of the regular season. Auburn Montgomery working quickly. They send this one in. Quick shot off the back, and it's in the back of the net. Folks, we are 20 seconds. Clock ticking, 22, 23. About 20 seconds as the clock continues to roll here. 20 seconds into the contest, and we'll try and make sense of this here in just a moment. If you just joined us or you just blinked, you have missed the opening goal, Auburn Montgomery. With a goal just 20 seconds into this contest. Hunter Lee, you're still scribbling some notes, I believe, here, and Bethel is trailing 1-0.
Yeah, Wade, just as I looked up, I saw the ball going into the back of the net. Pretty sure that was Franco Varga there.
Yannick Follett, the offensive player of the year in the Southern States Athletic Conference, finds the back of the net. And 44-43. They officially mark it 17 seconds into this contest here. And the Bethel University Wildcats are somewhat stunned right now. AUM controlled possession. It was a cross whipped in the bottom left corner of your screen here. And just like that, Auburn Montgomery able to capitalize on the goal from Fowlick. And we've got a quick foul. And let's see if this game doesn't turn testy early. As our wind chill dips down in the mid-30s. That foul was on Benjamin Sweet. So Auburn Montgomery sizing this one up will be Latico. He sends this one, good-looking ball, back post. No one home. Bethel with a clearance. First ever appearance in SSAC tournament action in the men's soccer or women's soccer championship, that is, for Bethel University. Wildcats made the opening round both years, but were eliminated on those match days both last year and this year. Now they find themselves trailing on their lead just 17 seconds into the contest. Unbelievable.
Absolutely unbelievable, Wayne.
Here's a quick effort as they send this one out wide now. This is a good looking for Arneson. Sends it over. AUM is buzzing to start this contest. We're less than 2 minutes in. There's Fowlick hand fighting in the corner, and we're going to get a corner kick given. AUM likes to pounce early on teams. They fell behind, believe it or not, in their contest against Belhaven last Saturday, but they rattled off three straight goals to claim a 3-1 win. This will be, looks like Metzinger sending this one in. Back post, someone was there. But Bethel, fortunately, no one able to finish. AUM continuing to apply the pressure. Now here come the Wildcats. They send a long ball. That one just brought down. And we'll have an injury. And we have an injured Warhawk here with 42-16 remaining in the first half. Yannick Fowlick is down right now. Or excuse me, that's Latico. Hopefully that young man is okay. Tough to see. All the action was on the counterattack there. And Vladico went down. Kind of in a heap right there. We've seen in all three of our previous games, with the temperatures and the wind whipping, we've seen some teams take some knocks today. And a simple stomp on the toe or ankle hurts that much worse when you're dealing with 35-degree wind chill like we are this evening. And hopefully Vladiko's okay. Looks like he will be.
Yeah, he's looks like he's ready to check back in.
Wolf Kutch on the sideline.
As soon as play resumes, and yeah, he'll walk back onto the pitch.
Easy to spot big coach Wolf Kutch on the sideline there. Got the black and gold. Looks like a Pittsburgh Steelers most out there with his jacket he's selected for his game day attire.
Could be Pittsburgh Steelers colors or could be Bethel Wildcat colors, whichever way you want to look at it.
Both coaches, Coach Belong and Coach Wolf Kutch, two of the best in the NAI. That's what makes this matchup so intriguing. Melvin Belong with a national title under his belt, and Coach Kutch with four runner-up finishes to his resume. This one pumped into the box. Headed around, and Hit Pass will come out and collect that one rather easily.
You mentioned Wolf Kutch's four runner-up appearances in the national tournament. And looks like he'll be taking on the team that defeated him on Saturday last year in the national tournament. If they're able to win today, they'll face the Martin Methodist College Redhawks.
That would be a sweet measure of revenge, no doubt, to possibly extract. Still a long way to go. Clock stops, or excuse me, foul called with 41 minutes remaining here in the first half. As this is Bethel now. AUM sending this one. A lot of crisscrossing here, ping-ponging. Some fans have braved the elements here tonight. Mostly Auburn Montgomery supporters, but a few Bethel Wildcat fans in attendance as well. 1-0, your score. Yannick Falick, 17 seconds into the contest, gave Bethel the lead. Bethel has since responded. For a couple of moments there, they were somewhat shell-shocked. They've now started to venture into the Auburn Montgomery into the field, still seeking their first shot attempt of the contest, however. This one is sent on. Auburn Montgomery playing in a familiar surroundings. They play several of their matches this season at the Emory Folmar YMCA complex. Foul called there. You still would have to go the same direction. I believe that was Budic going to be called for the foul.
Yeah, keep in mind AUM in the first meeting between these two teams. They were able to build a 2-0 lead. Saw that lead dwindle down to one and then ended up being a 2-2 draw.
There's a shot. Hit Pass able to slide underneath that one. Quick release. Thought I heard a whistle blow, but now we do. An official whistle as this one will go out of touch. It'll be a throw in for the Wildcats. Wildcats work quickly. This one ping ponged around. That was Linsworth Daly, number three on your screen there at the bottom for Bethel. Controlled it briefly. Now it's sent along here. This is a promising run. Low cross, and they're going to say offside. Look like Franco Varga maybe just an extra step ahead of that last Bethel defender. Actually, that was Metzinger. Beg pardon. Play is settled down. Hard not to settle down after that 17-second first goal. AUM punted it deep into the bottom left corner. Cross came in. And it was a goal shot there. Not much of a test for Weir, but he's able to, or excuse me, Weir is able to corral that one.
It looked like Metzinger on there.
See, Metzinger get pretty active in the final third, so to speak, for AUM already going. And the wind has returned big time here in this contest. We mentioned it in all three of our previous broadcasts, so we would be remiss if we didn't mention it here. AUM is enjoying a huge boost with the wind at their back, racing onto this one. And that was a decent effort from Fowlick, but he's unable to control it. But the Fowlick unable to come up with that one there. German national junior, 5'11", listed at 155 pounds. Showed good pace there. Let's see how the Wildcats approach this now. We've seen it happen to some teams this year. Give up an early goal and suddenly your whole game plan can kind of be thrown out the window. Here's AUM and a foul going to go against the Wildcats. Arneson drawing that one. You'd expect the foul count would be high in this contest, two high-energy teams. AUM came into this contest with 54 goals scored, 23 conceded. Bethel, 44 scored, 26 conceded. Two pretty good offenses on display this evening. Good run down the right side wing. Tough to see who poked that one out. And it'll be an AUM throw-in. Able to maintain possession. Good-looking cross into the box. Headed on! Draw side netting. Good effort right there. I believe that was Fowlick who got ahead to it.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Drew it on the side netting right there. There's correction. Yeah, it was Fowlick. Fowlick did a great job of planting his feet, whipping his head, drawing some extra pace on that one. And Weir luckily didn't have to make a save attempt on that one because that was coming with some velocity. Bethel, meanwhile, they're looking to establish a little bit of an offensive rhythm themselves. As you alluded, 2-2 draw when these teams met regular season. A little over 10 minutes gone by, first half. As this one is hit long. Able to corral that one. Good defense right there. It was Grabelny able to secure it. Strong, tall center back. A lot of German nationals on this team for Auburn Montgomery, as you might expect. Coach Wolf Koch, one of the best recruiters in the NAIA. This one flicked on. And Bethel unable to really establish attacking presence in the early goings. Match still very early, however. And we've seen it in all three of our contests. Counterattack and especially with the wind. Weir launches this one. Good looking effort into the teeth of this wind. And this one shot long now. Coming down, good low-range effort. That one, however, sails out of touch. It'll be a Bethel throw-in. Wildcats still trying to piece together an attacking effort. As we've got a Warhawk down stretching out a little bit here. I believe that was Fowlick. Maybe took a small bumper bruise there.
Yeah, he's getting up. He looks like he's okay, Wade.
Bethel on a five-match win streak entering this contest. AUM won their last outing, as we referenced earlier, against Bellhaven. And this will be a goal kick. Center ref adamant about that. He had a good, clear, unobstructed view. And after 12 minutes, AUM's 17-second goal stands as the lone tally thus far here in Montgomery. This one's sent long. Weir's getting good distance despite the fact he's kicking into 15 to 20-mile-an-hour winds out here. Montgomery going to play this one back. Hit pass. We mentioned first-team all-conference selection last night at the awards banquet. Was one of the premier goalkeepers in the national tournament last year, as mainly used as a reserve for Auburn Montgomery. That shot was blocked. Good defensive battle right here brewing. Down that left side. That was Arneson coming out with it again. Turning this one outside the 18s, Vladico. AUM doing a great job of maintaining possession thus far. Good block there by the Wildcat defender. That was Kirchner, Vinicius Kirchner. This one now sent long. Bethel got to be careful here. Assistant ref calls for a foul. Foul given. 31 minutes exactly remaining here in the first half. And Weir will be awarded a free kick here.
It looks like Yannick Fowlick just stepped off the field.
Alan Harwell will step into the contest. Local product, Alan Harwell. So Fowlick will take a seat as the Montgomery native will step on to the pitch. And if there's one thing we can tell you about Alan Harwell, he's got some pace. The question will be now, how will Coach Wolfkotch deploy Mr. Harwell here? The junior, we know he's got some great speed. We've seen him also be shifted into a defensive role here at times this season. This one headed on. For the time being, looks like he'll play in a center, maybe more, a little bit more of an attacking role. This one nearly flicked on. 4-1, your shot count. Two shots on goal for Auburn Montgomery. The designated guest, Auburn Montgomery. Home on the scoreboard, however, this evening. They're wearing the road orange and black uniforms. As this one punted deep, and looks like that one should go out for a Auburn Montgomery throw-in. They are going to credit the goal to Vargo, back that we mentioned earlier, officially. Fowlick was credited with the assist. There was some question in the press box here. That was a 12-second goal, in fact. 22, correction, and it's going to be credited to Vargas. We wanted to clear that up there. Either way, still a blistering pace, and now we've got Bethel going to take its first real true set piece of the match. Comes at the 29-18 mark. This one's sent in. Headed on, good effort. That one takes a nice header to keep it off the line. That takes a deflection. Bethel got to be careful here, and they'll drop this one all the way back to Weir. We are doing a good job of coming up and giving his defenders some relief. But good pressure being applied by the Warhawks. Knocked around. Remember, Fowlett just came off. We mentioned he got credited with the assist on the first goal. He was also subbed off just a moment ago. Harwell still really yet to take a touch in the early goings.
Yeah, we've seen last year Harwell played up top for the AU defense. A lot more involved last year as an offensive player, but this year had a different role, had to play a little bit more defense. Did an overall job in both positions.
This one will be played back. Weir's getting impressive distance, driving into a stiff breeze here. Looked like Errol Reed took a shot on the shoulder there. Throw in awarded to Bethel. And we've got a card coming. Let's check the card here. It's straight yellow. Errol Reed. And he's receiving a stern talking to. Yeah. We just mentioned that Reed was a little frustrated with some action earlier, and we didn't get a great look at it, but there's a Warhawk down. You can only assume that Reed maybe bumped into him, maybe a little aggressively.
That was Ingo Arneson down after that yellow card given to Errol Reed.
So Reed is still favoring that right shoulder, as you can see there.
Arneson looks like he's okay.
Arneson will be okay, but our official immediately taking charge, saying, not on my watch. We're going to keep this one pretty tight. Clock was stopped with exactly 28 minutes remaining.
Buttigieg.
This one headed forward. Now, UM fans trying to get some chance going, and now we've got a foul in the back, or up top, I should say, for the Warhawks. That was Franco Varga. Got the game's lone goal as Weir will trot over for the free kick. Been a great day of soccer here, semifinal Thursday, second round of the conference championships, two men's contest tonight, two women's contests we had this morning. All three matches have been pretty entertaining. All three matches were two goals or less. As here's Reed back to the goal. He draws a foul. Not much in that one. Is Arneson. Those two going at it yet again. And then Arneson this time picks up the foul.
It'd be Kirchner here taking this free kick. Varga will be the only person in the vicinity of Vinicius.
Yeah, they're almost going to just concede a direct kick here in favor of just marking up. Hit pass is targeting this one. It does a great job of reading that one the entire way. In the wind, that is extremely impressive goalkeeping.
Yeah, hit pass is definitely a commanding goalkeeper. He likes to establish his presence in the box.
Meanwhile, got a streaking run. This is Harwell looking for his first touch. Making a run onto it. Still got some space. And this will be last touch by the Wildcats. That was Baron Watson over there on that sideline. They're on the far side. Tough for us to view. But with 25:55 remaining. AUM looking for a possible second goal here, midway stages of the first half. They clear this one. That was Goni. Reed also tracking it. And this one will trickle all the way back. 4-2, we mentioned the shots. 2-1 on goal. Auburn Montgomery taking a lead just 22 seconds in. Good little 1-2 play here, but the official will halt the play. We'll bring it back. Thought we might see an advantage call.
Oh, yeah, with the mold in it. Yeah,
but no from the official here.
Yeah, quit buying them. Yeah, clear.
25 minutes now. And intended for Reed.
Just a thought of it.
Solid clearance right there. By Varga, dropping back in a defensive role. Bethel working now. Left side of the box. Clever little back heel. Decent run. Middle of the box. Play on, says the official. Here's Reed. Left-footed shot. That one blocked away. Now a chance to spring a counterattack here. Warhawks had numbers. It looks like Bethel may have sustained the attack there. Here come the Wildcats marching down now on their own. Decent through ball. That one will be whisked away. Game really starting to settle into a good little groove here on a cold Thursday night in Montgomery. This one popped up. Good win right here by Guncal. Play on, says the official. AUM, deep ball. That one will not make a clearance over the center back. Orr with a great header to glance that one, allow his defensive mates to return here. Now another header, this time from Benjamin Sweet. It'll lead to a corner, but it could have been a lot worse there for the Wildcats. 1-0 your score, AUM leading here. Semifinal number two.
Lucas Metzinger here on the court.
We've seen Metzinger take these. Metzinger also kind of involved on the buildup there on that first AUM goal. They scored just 22 seconds in. And this one played long.
Looked like it was Varga trying to get ahead on it. Ball sailed over his head. Weir will take a goal kick here.
We are standing back there. He's had some good kicks into this wind. Wind has died off just a little bit since we kicked off, but not much. Had rain this morning. This one is played on. Ooh, that was close to being onside. Flag goes up. And the Wildcats will get a free kick. Pop-up rain shower. Heavy rain right in the midst of the second half of the highly entertaining Mobile and Auburn Montgomery women's contest.
Yeah, luckily that rain moved on, but left cold behind.
Left the cold behind indeed. This one headed on. Bethel's trying to pop free on a breakout. This is a shot again into the side netting.
That's Kebadimba there.
Coach Belong is furious, begging for a call in the box. But a solid effort right there by Keba Dimba. Dimba's got 7 goals on the season. Nearly had an 8th right there. That's 2 times now we've seen both teams nearly put one in and they've just gone off to side netting. Goal kick coming from hip pass. He puts a missile onto this one. AUM able to control as well. If you just joined us, Yannick Follick subbed off midway through this half as a great through ball. Flag stays down. Shot is on the way. It's high. Had some pace. Would have found the roof of the net, but just sailed over the crossbar. Otherwise, we're talking 2-0 Auburn Montgomery. A beautiful through ball that had a tremendous shot attached to it at the end. Just high.
Not the first time we've seen one sail over the crossbar due to the wind. Going at such a high speed, the closer you get, the lower you have to kick it.
Coming up on 20 minutes to play now. Field number 2 here at this gorgeous facility. We'll play our championships on Saturday, men and women, on field 1. Considering this is the approaching 3.5 worth of games today, including overtime and 2 shootouts, Field's actually held up pretty well today.
Absolutely has, Wade.
Good little touch passing going on as here's Kirchner looking to find Reed. Reed with a cute little flick up in the air. That one unable to finish, however. Play still being controlled here by the Wildcats. AUM, however, leading on the scoreboard. As we tick under 20 minutes remaining. And hit pass will just casually watch this one bounce at his feet, and he'll collect it in the box. Saw it come from behind of sorts for Martin Methodist in our first semifinal. They were trailing around this mark before they tied it up in the second half and advanced via a penalty kick shootout.
And we know Bethel's had a few comeback draws and wins this season.
Bethel coming from behind to draw AUM and to knock off Martin Methodist in the regular season.
They faced a 2-0 deficit early in the second half there against Martin Methodist to come back and win.
But right now, AUM is able to withstand the pressure. Bethel, however, is capable of making some changes tactically and flipping this game in a more offensive direction. AUM also capable of that, as here we see Harwell trying to break free on a run. Flag goes up, offside is the call. Harwell popped free. We mentioned his speed. He's got plenty of it, but that time he was too much offside. Flag is up again for offside, and this one will come back. So teams just now trading runs down the flank. And they're just unable to time them. Hit pass will come out, and if his last kick was any indication, this one might end up in the box. I'm not sure if I'm Bethel. I'm not sprinting all the way back to the box right now.
Yeah, don't see very many AUM players moving towards the goal.
And you see hit pass motioning. He says, scoot up, scoot up. Wind at his back, he sends one floating. Good straight ahead defensive header. I believe that was Orr that got it. AUM, though, takes over. Sloppy clearance. This one sent in, headed high. That was a good looking effort from Varga, just like we saw on the game's opening goal. Much stronger defensive effort there in the middle from the Wildcat defense. And now we've got a foul.
A little trip up on Kebadimba there.
Kebadimba, who narrowly missed a goal earlier with the trip up. We've also got a Warhawk down near mid-pitch. He's up and
not
okay.
Sure. It was B.J. Watson, not sure what he was doing. Maybe getting a quick stretch in or something. But
some looks, yoga out there.
Otherwise looks to be fine.
16-15, he appears to be fine. This will be a low ball sent in, running onto this one, and Krish Patel unable to curl that one enough to get it and keep it in. Sailing past the end line as we tick under 16 minutes here in the first half. We mentioned it's Bethel University's first ever appearance here in Montgomery. And this one is going to be a turnover. Flag is down again. Varga nearly with the perfect through ball, just a touch too far for Metzinger. Otherwise, we could have been talking about 2-0.
Yeah, Metzinger had a golden opportunity there. Mark Weir very quick off his line.
Seen that so many times today. The goalkeepers are popping off the line rather quickly today. With the field maybe a little soggy from some of the rain. Ball's going to be slower, so the goalkeeper's not leaving anything to chance. They're going to go out there and tidy it up themselves. And here's Weir going to collect this one. the women's contest that was played last week. AUM women, the 5 seed, go on the road to knock off the Bethel 4th seeded women. That was the lone upset of the opening round in women's play. No upsets in the opening round of the men's bracket. This one popped back. Weir's got to come out and get rid of this one. Auburn Montgomery still leading 1-0, 14-15 remaining. A goal that came 22 seconds into the game. We don't have our official SSAC record book with us, but you got to imagine that's one of the fastest goals in tournament history. It came in the blink of an eye for Coach Wolf Koch's side here. And for Coach Melvin Belong, his marker had hardly set on his dry erase board before the goal came in. Here's a ball in the box, knocked away. I believe they're going to say corner kick given. Be the third corner kick of the evening for the Warhawks.
Be Vladico taking this corner for the Warhawks.
Sebastian Vladico will send this one in. Set pieces have been hard to deliver from the corner sometimes with the wind whipping in. It'll take a ball that's headed right toward the center of the box and push it wide or push it long. As we've got another injured Warhawk here, and this time I believe it's Krish Patel. Correction, that'll be Nicholas. He's holding his back here. We saw Yannick Falik exit earlier due to injury.
Yeah, Hunold's going to come off, and the big man Pedro Antonelli is going to come on for the Warhawks.
So Antonelli comes in.
Also, we had...
it's like Rick Rocchio came in.
Yeah, we had Samuel Goney come off for the Bethel Wildcats.
Rocchio was a conference player of the week earlier this season. Great effort. Good-looking in-swinger here. Good punch by Weir. Got two hands on it and got a lot on it. A tough kick goes off the chest there on the far side. Under 13 minutes now. And our officials are going to halt play again here for some reason. The officials certainly running a tight ship today. Fresh onto the contest. Here's a great-looking ball. Second shot saved by Weir.
Metzinger had a clear opening for that goal.
Metzinger, all he had to do was pick his side, right or left. And he picked right, just left it a little too centered and allowed Weir to get a fingertip to it. Great save by Mark Weir.
Another great job by Weir.
Had 68 saves during the regular season and their opening round contest. And that one was huge because it was destined to be too for that individual effort right there.
Also one of Antonelli coming on.
Antonelli set that play up.
Yeah. He's a big Brazilian coming on for the Warhawks, a transfer. Listed at 6'3".
6'3", 220. And excuse me, 230.
And
the only player on the active roster over 200 for the Warhawks.
Yeah, scored 10 goals this season. Definitely a big physical presence up
big
there.
Big fella, for sure. 11:25 remaining now. They 22 seconds was all that it took for a stroke of magic from the Warhawks. They conceded a goal first in their opening round match against Belhaven. Then they rattled off 3 straight goals. Win that contest 3-1. There comes Bethel trying to link something in the middle. That one will be sent away. Antonelli was lurking in the middle there. They flick on for him. Can he make a charge?
He's going for it.
He was going for it, and the defender just had to turn that one out of play.
That was a good job by Linsworth Daly there to clear that one.
Daly's been quiet, but he's been effectively quiet. We can say that maybe here. 10:33. And this one will be sent back to Weir. We mentioned that game against Belhaven. Belhaven actually had to wear Auburn Montgomery's jerseys during that game. There was a mix-up with their equipment. And so the Warhawks had two sets of kits out on the field, one for Belhaven and one for Auburn Montgomery. They actually were trailing to themselves, I guess, if you will, at least in terms of the jersey. But we mentioned the three straight goals. They secured the 3-1 win, and that got them to this semifinal. This one will be sent forward. And Antonelli is swarming to the ball after coming on for the injury a moment ago.
Yeah, Antonelli started 11 of the 18 games that he appeared in.
This one takes a flick. Bethel, man, onside. Hit pass there to secure that one. Took an odd carom off the Auburn Montgomery defender at the 9:30 mark here. Hit pass will drop it to his feet. Looks like Luke Sellers is up and loose for Bethel. He may check on here at the next opportunity. Good chance at a through ball here. Flag is down. Good-looking effort here for Skyers.
Tevin Skyers able to send balls in for goals. He had one of the assists on one of the goals in the comeback draw against AUM earlier in the season for Bethel.
Bethel's struggled at times to get the ball into the corners offensively. They've had to attack kind of through the center of the AUM defense, whereas Auburn Montgomery's been able to attack from a number of different angles. This play will be halted here for Sellers to come on. Luke Sellers making his 12th appearance of the season. Eight of those games have been starts. He's got one assist on the year, six shots. So
he'll replace Kirshner.
A little bit more of a defensive substitution, perhaps. Maybe just try and get this thing to halftime, only trailing by a goal. Bethel with possession, however. Dancing on the far side there. Now deep in the left corner. That's going to be impossible for us to determine, but the official's got a pretty good angle, and he says that ball belongs to the Warhawks. Auburn Montgomery with 7:50 remaining. Second seed Bethel, third seed AUM. AUM trying to link something together here now before the break. Bethel trying to stagger into halftime and regather themselves. We've seen Coach Belong make some magical adjustments at halftime in games this season. Wildcats with a good-looking run here right now. This will be Linsworth Daly. Miscommunication there. Now look out.
That's Arneson there. He
Arneson
slips.
Nearly had a chance at a breakaway. Linsworth Daly flicks it on. Flag stays down. Reed is charging in. Hit pass. Able to pick that one up. Booming kick. Antonelli, meanwhile, like a runaway freight train, tracking this one down. And
he will send that one.
And we mentioned it earlier, he sent that one to Prattville on a left-footed volley. That one a little bit optimistic, to say the least.
Yeah, Coach Wolfkotch screaming from the sideline, Pedro, you need to know where you are. A little bit similar to Coach Chris Leonardi screaming at one of the Redhawks in the previous game.
We've seen some animated coaches here this evening, no doubt. Antonelli had the cavalry's support coming, but he just rifled the shot well over the frame of goal. That wind is picked back up. Flags are buzzing here at the Montgomery Soccer Stadium. Bethel's kicking right into the teeth of this wind here. 6 minutes remaining. Wildcats down a goal. Good-looking ball into the box. Headed up, and that will be a harmless. I believe that's Kirchner, maybe. Got his head on that one. And that shot goes out of touch. It'll be a goal kick for Hit Pass. With the wind like it is right now, I'm curious to see where Hit Pass places this one.
Yeah, and it looks like AUM's going to hold back again. I'm sure Hit Pass, well, he plays it short, actually. Maybe trying to hold it until halftime.
Perhaps. We've seen Hit Pass begging for his players to get forward. This time they just play it short. Here's Antonelli with it. Good little step over, and he commits the foul.
Yeah, I'm sure Coach Wolf Koch would rather have the boys burn some time and bring the ball down the field than send a long one and have it rebounded back for a Bethel counterattack.
Bethel not interested in developing some passing there. They're just going to boot kind of a direct style pass. This one takes a bounce, headed back. They're just trading kicks here now.
Yep.
Winner advances to Saturday's championship.
Hey, it works good though. What are you talking about?
Against Martin Methodist, the fourth seed. First real upset in either bracket, certainly since we've been here in Montgomery. The fifth seed AUM women's soccer team knocked off Bethel in their matchup. That was a 5-4 matchup. But no upsets here seed-wise in Montgomery. This one played up top. That was Dimba. Ball settled rather nicely. A lot of hand fighting in the box. Ball is free. And that's a goal. Errol Reed. Dimba was able to slide through the defense. Reed was able to battle off a defender. And Errol Reed has got the Wildcats dancing. We're level here. 1-1 with 3:59 before the break. Hunter, we thought we might see Coach Melvin Belong back off and maybe try and just preserve the one-goal deficit. But Reed, with a great bit of individual skill, able to carve through and draw level just before the break.
Yeah, Errol Reed was able to take that ball. Was met with a challenge by one of the AUM defenders, able to out-physical that defender, get past, put a move on Philip Pittpass, and had an empty net.
Beautiful move by Reed. Pittpass was going for the ball. Tough to fault him there, but Reed had a wide-open net and capped it off with a little dance outside the box. Sudden ball game. One team scored 22 seconds into the first half, the other scoring just 3 minutes and 52 seconds remaining in the first half. 1-1 our score. I'm curious to see. Now you would imagine both coaches would be conservative here before halftime, get to the break, tied just 1-1, but who knows the way this has gone.
Yeah, neither team wants to give up a late goal here in this first half. You definitely don't want to create the scenario where you're going into the second half down one.
You hear coaches say that all the time. The most important thing is to not give up a goal just before the break. That's the one that can hurt your psyche the most. Weir will come out, and this will be a goal kick here with 2:45 remaining. Weir's going to take his time. Spot this one up. Errol Reed from Keba Dimba.
Reed perhaps relieving a little bit of frustration from earlier in this half.
This one is intended, sorry, Hunter, for Varga, knocked out of play. Be a throw-in heading Bethel's direction as we tick under 2 minutes. Yeah, Reed already picking up that one yellow card.
Mm-hmm.
Got involved with Arneson in kind of a shoving match.
Yeah, showed a little bit of frustration took his yellow, and he bounced back with an equalizing goal here late in the second or first half, excuse me.
This one flicked ahead. Nice little give and go. Weir, though, charging out of the box off his line.
Yeah, we saw that ball sail a little bit. The through balls have took some fairly quick bounces here. Keepers have been able to get to them going with the wind.
This one, contact, advantage being played. Another through ball, and just as you mentioned, through balls are cutting through this grass rather quickly here. 60 seconds till halftime. The goals coming in rapid fire. Varga with the goal, 22 seconds in for Auburn Montgomery. Errol Reed with just under 4 minutes remaining for Bethel. Bethel just continuing to fire these through balls, trying to strike. Down to 30 seconds.
Looks like hit pass
hit
is
pass
going
probably
for
should
it.
Go. Yeah, probably go for one more long ball while you've got the wind at your back here.
Man, Antonelli unable to settle that one.
And this will be, after such a promising start, maybe a disappointing finish to the first half for AUM if they
10, 9,
can't capitalize 8, here. And Reed 7, will 6, touch this one one more time. 5, in fact, he'll draw a
4,
foul.
3,
and
2,
that will take
1.
Us. To the half.
Half time, the score, half time.
Entertaining
Bethel
as
Wildcats
predicted.
One.
First half, 1-1. It was 22 seconds into the contest that AUM stormed ahead. But with just moments before the break, Errol Reed and the Bethel Wildcats have drawn level. We expected a tight, entertaining ball game, and thus far, 45 minutes in, Hunter, we've seen exactly just that.
Yeah, we'll definitely be seeing another entertaining second half as both teams are going to look to reach Saturday's final.
Some adjustments to be made, maybe some cocoa to be drank, at least for us here in the press box, as we take our halftime timeout. 45 minutes to decide a winner when we come back on the other side. You're listening to the SSAC Men's Soccer Championship here on the SSAC Sport Network. Second half of our final matchup here on Semifinal Thursday, Southern States Athletic Conference Men's Soccer Championship coming to a close in 45 minutes, or maybe not. We'll find out here in just a little bit. 1-1 your score. Very entertaining first half between the second-seeded Bethel Wildcats and the third-seeded Auburn Montgomery Warhawks. He's Hunter Lee. I'm Wade Neely. Hunter, if the second half is anything like the first, we're in store for a good one.
Oh, yeah, we definitely are, Wade. And if past meetings mean anything, we're tied up at 1-1 here. Last time they tied up at 2-2. And no penalty kicks in the regular season, but here.
That's certainly a possibility. We've already seen two sets of penalty kicks taken today, one in our first women's game and one in our first men's game.
Yeah, third of this postseason here in the conference tournament.
So three sets of penalties have been taken overall. The other one being a home campus penalty kick shootout for Martin Methodist in men's soccer. The Red Hawks coming up with another big win today. They advanced. They're the reigning champions, and they've still got a pulse here in this tournament. The winner will meet Martin Methodist in Saturday's final. 1:30 is the kickoff time.
Yeah, a little bit.
As some of the Bethel Wildcats are late to get on the pitch, Errol Reed, who had the magic dust sprinkled in his boots late in the first half. He had the goal. He is literally sprinting onto the field with just seconds to spare. Maybe getting some final instruction or maybe just a final few seconds of warmth because it is frigid out here in Montgomery, Alabama tonight.
Definitely frigid, Wade. Wind's still blowing. Constant speed. Hasn't really stopped. It's going to be either an advantage or a burden for this Bethel Wildcat offense here, as we saw for many of the teams today.
Yeah. Whether it's an advantage or a burden, as you put it, Hunter, we'll find out here in a minute. But you're right. Some teams have struggled going into the win. Some teams have thrived on it. So tonight we will see how it treats the Bethel Wildcats. They are hovering over the ball. They will kick things off here in period number two. They will move right to left on your television screen, your internet device. A lot of folks have stuck with us for all four matches today. For those of you that have joined us, we say thank you. Hunter and I have truly enjoyed bringing to you every single one of these games this evening. As we've got a delayed now we're set to kick things off here in just a little bit. It was a brief intermission there. Now we're finally back to action. One note we did want to remind you, Hunter, there was some major confusion. If you just joined us, 22 seconds was all that it took for Auburn Montgomery to jump in front. We initially credited the goal as Bethel here takes over on this possession. Hard foul to start this one. We initially credited the goal to Yannick Falick with an assist from Franco Varga. The official scoring came out later in the period and said that it was reversed. Well, at halftime, they got together with the coaches and the officials. They have since re-reversed it. So it was Yannick Falick with the goal for Auburn Montgomery.
Yeah, assisted by Franco Varga on that one.
So Franco Varga collects the assist. And AUM is off and running here. As Pedro looking shot, hit pass got a hand on it. It'll be a corner.
Yeah, hit pass was on the ground right there, and we watched the ball skirt right by the post.
Good looking effort right there. Going to be a corner kick awarded.
Got a corner here for Kirshner. And the corner flag is bending. The wind is blowing so hard.
The wind is absolutely piercing here this evening. Both the corner flag and the assistant referee's flag are just whipping right there, as you can see on our camera shot. Our great camera crew, we got to thank Spencer, Lane, Phil, Our producer, Scott Chaney, and our photographer, Guy, doing some terrific work behind the scenes to help make this broadcast look fantastic. Braving the elements.
I was going to say
literally,
braving the elements.
Pouring down rain and now braving a huge windstorm. We've got an injury on the near sideline here. That's what the delay is.
That's B.J. Watson there.
Baron Watson is down right in front of the AUM dugout. That's why it's tough to see right there. And that would be the third loss. Correction, that was the Bethel dugout. That would be the third loss due to injury in this half.
Yeah, it looked for a second like Metzinger was going to come check in for Watson, but I think Watson's going to try and collect himself and stay on the pitch.
So now, corner kick.
It's Kirshner.
Kirshner sends it in. Headed effort.
Varga on the clear there.
Antonelli comes flying in. Fun to watch Antonelli come crashing down. We mentioned earlier 230 pounds, but he's got some wheels out there, so you've got to take Pedro seriously back there, as this one will be trickled back to Hip Pass. Hip Pass made that touch save. Otherwise, Bethel could have drawn ahead. This is a foul on Goncalves. That's Gilmar. He started 15 games this year, made 15 appearances. Beautifully laced ball sent ahead.
Yeah, you saw Harwell streaking, using his speed to get ahead.
Harwell was streaking. That ball actually looked more like a shot than a through ball, unfortunately, for AUM. And Bethel will take over with possession here. They worked this one. Bethel's goal came just 3.5 minutes before the end of the first half, as a foul will be called here. And there's a Bethel player down. Clock stoppage here. We've gone about 15 minutes of real time here to play about 3.5 minutes of game time in the second half.
That's David Orr down.
Orr, a key cog, too, of the Bethel defense in the first half. Had a couple of nice headers in the box. So if he can't be up to full speed, that would be a big loss. Bethel Wildcats looking to get back defensively now here. Good-looking ball streaking. Weir thought about coming out. Now he backtracks. Second shot lasered across the face of goal. And that'll go out for a throw. Believe that one was rocketed out of the back right there.
It looked like it was Daniel Grabelny there.
Grabelny just with a smash that flew across the face of goal. Weir with some indecisiveness on coming out right there.
And you saw on that cross there, the ball just lingers in the air. The wind blowing in the opposite direction. Plenty of time for the AUM offense to figure out what they were going to do.
Antonelli was pursuing that one, cut out by the Bethel defense. This one headed on. AUM working. Now it's Christian Young recently into the ball game. Millbrook, Alabama native, just a freshman. Boxing right here. Boxing out a defender, would-be defender. We mentioned first half was highly entertaining. We said in our pregame open, we thought this might be the most entertaining contest on the slate today. It is yet to disappoint. Here's a ball being hooked. Upper right corner. Tough to tell if that was a cross or a shot. Looked like a cross initially, but it just kept floating toward that upper right corner. The wind wreaking havoc with some of these efforts from distance today.
Yeah, we've mentioned it countless times, and it's still in play tonight. Not letting up at all.
AUM will launch an attack now. Bethel cuts that out. It'll be a foul at the center stripe here. Little less than 5 minutes gone by in the second half. It's 1-1, Bethel and AUM. Second-seeded Wildcats, third-seeded berth in the SSAC title game on Saturday on the line. Here's Antonelli trying to fight for this one. There's a foul going to be called. Outside the box, we may see a card here.
Clock stoppage.
If nothing else, we'll at least see Stern talking to.
Yeah, official's digging in his pocket. Looks like he's going to pull out a yellow, waiting to issue it, and it's going against Orr.
So Orr, who picked up a knock on an injury earlier, is now going to have to be saddled with a yellow card for the remainder of this contest.
We got Sebastian Vladico here, looking like he might take this free kick. Vladico with a strong leg, definitely in range.
Four goals, 11 assists for Vladico on the season.
Could possibly go for a goal here.
Vladico listed as a defender out of Rangsdorf, Germany. Business administration major, but 6'2", 190 pounds, and he has a titanium leg fastened to his frame there.
And this official's definitely going to back up the wall of Bethel. They were within 5 yards away from Vladico. Vladico said, I don't think so.
No vanishing spray here tonight, but Vladico now has got his 10 yards. And the German national stands over this one. Left-footed attempt. Knuckling near the side post. Almost with a majestic finish there.
Goodness, Wade. The ball had some pace on it. Against the wind.
Against the wind, it was diving right toward the bottom corner. As Vladico nearly put AUM ahead 2-1. Now a little bit of a confused back line there as Grabelny just boots that one out. This one's sent in by Bethel. That was Errol Reed coming in. He's got the goal for the Wildcats. There's a shot in front of the frame. Tough to see who touched that one. Looked like hit pass and was able to poke it loose for Auburn Montgomery. Curious to see if this game opens up or shrinks a little bit with the 1-1 advantage. You would think that would lead to some more open play here. It's been entertaining thus far in the second half.
Yeah, I doubt either team is going to hold back here. Definitely going to look for an early goal. You definitely want to be playing with a lead rather than playing in a draw.
We have a pitch invader there briefly, but back off now.
Otherwise known as a ball girl.
She has stepped out for just a moment. Bethel trying to attack here. They're in the box. Going to be a corner kick conceded.
Oh, Samuel Goni there in the box.
Set pieces have been big time here tonight. Haven't directly contributed to as many goals as we had anticipated. Led to the own goal for the Mobile Rams, who were eliminated tonight in a penalty kick shootout. But we've seen several attacking balls. This will be a good corner kick coming in from Metzinger. This one's double hit, and it was a double header sent over to crossbar. Metzinger was taking those corners from that angle in the first half. As that one actually was taken by Kirchner. 37:05 remaining. Hunter touched on it earlier. 2-2 draw in what was a seesaw affair when these teams met during the regular season.
Definitely a seesaw affair, Wade, and definitely not the first time Bethel's been on one side of the seesaw and then back on the other side.
Bethel trying to string together possession here. This one a decent effort out to Sellers. Sellers checked on late in the first half. has remained on here in the second. If you're just joining us, three injuries already for Auburn Montgomery. Possibly a fourth right there as B.J. Watson went down. He's had that third injury earlier.
Yeah, that was in that same spot too.
He was almost clipped there. Here's Antonelli, and he boots this one. And, again, the wind is tough to compromise for. You want to make sure you get a good look on it. But Antonelli put way too much on it. Overcompensate. This one headed. Errol Reed is lurking. Flag should have gone up there, but possession picked up by Christian Young and AUM, so no flag called for from the assistant ref. This one is sent on, and hit pass will come out.
Dominic Budic is limping right now, favoring one of his ankles, maybe his foot for the Warhawks.
Philip hit pass, sophomore. Came onto the scene with a flurry in the national tournament a year ago for the Warhawks. Saw him take and stop several penalty kicks as the Warhawks had that magical run to the national title game last year.
Yeah, we spoke about his demanding presence in the box. He came on last year with a lot of confidence.
Came on as a backup, basically, yep. Used just for penalty kick situations.
Yeah, and short of a
this one played ball. Inside, nearly flicked on. That was a good-looking ball played into Samuel Goney. As Tevin Skyers, who assisted on the goal, one of the two goals when these teams met earlier in the regular season, nearly had another assist there. This is a good-looking drop-off now. Just outside the box, this is Keba Dimba, who did assist on the tally for Errol Reed earlier. And Bethel suddenly. Here comes another look. It's Skyers, and the shot is in. Tevin Skyers just turns and burns. Blows by a Warhawk defender and rifles one into the bottom right corner of the net. It's 2-1. Wildcats leading here in Montgomery.
Bethel 2.
We just mentioned Skyers and his ability to create plays. This time he takes matters into his own hands and puts the Wildcats ahead by a goal. 34-02 remaining in the contest.
Yeah, heck of a finish there by Skyers. Both goals scored by Bethel. Absolutely no doubt where they were going.
And we're going to have a card coming here as there's a jersey pull on the far side.
It looks like it's Harwell on the far side.
You would assume this will be just a yellow, but.
Unless he just wants to talk. Nope, he's showing that yellow. Be a yellow on Alan Harwell.
So Harwell enters the book. Harwell came on. For an injury. Just a yellow. You can see the outside of our official's pocketbook, however, does have a red card. He keeps that one in his pocket for right now.
Already seen two.
Seen a few. In our women's opener. Bethel, with the wind at its back, going to punt this one deep.
That 2-1
long-range effort. This one's sent wide.
Looking for a third goal. We've got a couple subs coming on for AUM here. It's going to be Metzinger and
coming in for AUM.
Looks like 16, Mathis Kroger.
Mathis Kroger and number 26, Lucas Metzinger.
Kroger and Metzinger come on.
Pedro Antonelli coming off. Franco Varga coming off.
So Varga checks out. He's got the assist.
Number nine comes off along
on the goal for AUM tonight. But Tevin Skyers assisting on one goal and finishing what would be currently the game-winning goal. Here's another one. Flag stays down. This off a ball from Reed. Chances on the way. It's wide.
Oh, my.
It was a gorgeous effort from Samuel Goney, but he just could not control it.
And that could have spelled disaster for the AUM Warhawks. You definitely don't want to go down 3-1 in any situation.
And this one, the official was standing there. He thought for a brief moment as if the flag was going to come up, but the flag stayed down. Maybe Goney was caught off guard.
Yeah, other than a little miscue on the direction there, that's probably one of the best balls we've seen played ahead, going with the wind. The keeper was not able to get to that ball in time and left the net otherwise wide open.
Heading for it here. Good-looking battle against B.J. Watson. And this game is probably going to start getting a little chippy with 32:02 remaining, 2-1. The Wildcats of Bethel have scored two goals in the last 25 or so minutes of gameplay after Auburn Montgomery went ahead 22 seconds into this contest. The official goal time was 34-20 on the go-ahead goal as hit pass corrals that loose ball. We'll set up a goal kick.
Yeah, you can expect the intensity to crank up here, especially as all three teams that are still remaining in this men's side not guaranteed a trip to the national tournament.
We mentioned earlier we would think AUM would have enough on a resume to get in, but never want to leave things up to the MRPI.
Yeah, definitely don't.
Here's a good-looking play by Young. Trying to do too much, though. Last touched by Young off the knee, they say, and it'll go out. It'll be a Bethel throw.
Yeah, Benjamin Sweet came out there and made a solid challenge.
Mathis Kroger immediately comes in. And we got an over-the-back, a little shoving foul. And as it stands, Bethel would advance. This is their first ever championship appearance. They were eliminated in the last year. And they're 30 minutes away from a trip to the final against arch rival Martin Methodist. That would be akin to Faulkner and AUM meeting in the title game. Giveaway here. Goney comes up with it. Working with it now on the left side of the box. There's an advantage called, and now finally play will be halted. A card will be issued.
Yeah, clock's going to stop there, Wade.
Yeah, that'll be Grabelny. Professional foul maybe on the outside there. Limit the goal-scoring opportunity. But Grabelny will be booked for that one.
Yeah, it was Kebedimba with the ball there. Took a tumble, but he already dropped the ball off. Referee knew it, but wanted to play advantage as they were so close to the opportunity.
You mentioned Dimba. He stands over this one. Wind is whipping. You would think Dimba would take a crack at goal here. Luke Seller is going to join the wall, try and cloud hit pass's vision even further. It's already a hefty wall. And they just inched forward a little bit.
Referee's not even paying attention.
The referee.
He's worried about booking Grabelny there.
Crafty move as the wall inched forward.
Yeah, he's going to scoot him back. He's going to say, no, sir. That's not going to happen on my watch.
And the official now, maybe they weren't officially set at 10 yards. So they'll mark him back just an inch or so. The ball definitely scooted up a little bit. Here's Kebedimba. Will he lay this one off or we go for glory here? It's an angled shot, and that one sails over the crossbar. That one would have been good from 60 yards if this were the NFL. Yeah.
Unfortunately, you got to go in the goal, not over the goal.
Ted Lasso would have been proud of that effort. Noted soccer coach Ted Lasso. This one played on. This is Goney down to Reed, who's already sitting on one away. But Reed still fighting for it.
Reed also sitting with a yellow card. He's got to be careful there getting physical.
Good point, Hunter, as Reed was battling there for that one.
He was. He and Budic getting a little involved. Nothing comes of it, though.
But we've seen Reed's game. He was physical and picked up a yellow, and then he was also physical and battled his way to a shot on goal that turned into the equalizer for Bethel. His teammate, Tevin Skyers, has given Bethel a 2-1 lead with 28:57 remaining. This one booted now. Coming down to Skyers. Back out to Goney. Goney allows Dimba to run on top of it. Now back to Orr. Orr also sitting on a yellow. This one, small flick on, intended for Reed. Comes down to Skyers. Flag was probably going to go up, but that was easily cut out by Hit Pass. And Hit Pass booms this one despite the wind whipping in his face.
Yeah, we saw both Weir and Hit Pass now.
Christian Young giving chase. There's Kroger. Mathis Kroger can't buy a call right now. It's twice now he's been whistled for an elbow in the back on a jump ball.
Yeah, it looked like. Looks like Kevin Dimba may have taken a fall there.
Hit Pass. Boots this one. Been a while since we've really seen an attacking chance from Auburn here in the second half. Bethel's kind of just seized control of this ball game every second goal. And remember, Yannick Falik left with an injury. And also, Franco Varga has been out. But maybe that will change. Contact in the box. Crowd won't like it, but I believe we're going to have a foul call. And sure enough, here come the boos.
Yeah, well, AUM fans got to be happy that that wasn't more than just a foul call. Alan Harwell sitting with the yellow.
Astute observation, Hunter Lee. So now Weir will take his time. Winds still circling.
Rifle kick.
That one was absolutely thumped. They work with this one. They're trying to send Young down that right side. Instead, they trickle it back in the middle to Harwell. We mentioned Harwell. He's played all over the pitch this season for Auburn Montgomery. Applies his trade as an offensive. Also seen him playing defense for the Warhawks. This one sent deep. Reed with it. Working down the right wing. Reed making a run. Good defense to cut him off right there in the back by Krish Patel.
Nicholas Hunold.
This is a strike off a volley, a little half volley right there. Ball was not cleared entirely. And it was Skyers, I believe, that caught it on a little semi-volley. Put a good strike on it. Here's Goney racing down the left side. B.J. Watson giving pursuit. And we'll have a substitution.
Yeah, it's Nicholas Hunold who came off in the early in the or late in the first half with a back injury. Looked like he was rubbing his back as he was about to come back into the game.
So Hunold exits.
Hunold's in.
Or correction, Hunold returns, and it'll be.
He's replacing Kroger.
Kroger
just came in.
Who picked up two fouls. And we'll depart here. 24-48, still 2-1. The Wildcats of Bethel, their first ever championship here in Montgomery, as this one knocked away. Sellers has stayed in the ball game. This Bethel team, they've got a star on the crest. They've won the national championship under head coach Melvin B. Long. Here's a long-range effort, never really had a chance, but a ricochet comes down. Foul in the box, however. We'll take that one out.
That was Kreshner on that shot. Deflected.
On a blustery Thursday night in the capital city of Alabama, a team from Tennessee trying to come in and upset the home side. This one, beautifully played ball. Harwell's got to track it. It just went over his outside shoulder. If that had trickled inside, he would have been able to race onto it. Ball played in.
Play on.
Play on, say the officials. Deep ball played for Reed. This one will be dropped back. Hit pass will play it on the ground. Wild sequence right there. Both teams utilizing the deep ball. Good-looking flick here. Running onto this one. This is Metzinger. Ball played in the middle. Was a good effort. Center back did well to head that one away.
Yeah, that was Orr there with the head.
Orr had a brilliant clearance in the first half, and he adds another here in the second. But a corner kick is given. Wolf Koch. His bunch. As Franco Varga will check back in here in a moment. It'll be Vladico taking the corner. You can see the flag just whipping on your screen here. Here's Vladico. Shot in. Headed inward! Just over the crossbar. How many times have we said that today?
Too many times to count, Wade.
The headers have been unkind today for our teams in conference play. Grabelny, the latest to struggle to find the mark. Saw Mikey Fulton from Martin Methodist miss almost an identical header earlier in this contest. Semifinal matchup round.
Coming in for Bethel.
And that's Rick Rokel back into the lineup for the Bethel Wildcats.
Rick Rokel.
Christian Young will take a seat, and Franco Varga checking on.
Christian Young out for AUM.
Now this one being played on. That's Varga. They play it on to him. Good looking ball. One slots it over. Sit high. And that one will haunt Alan Harwell.
Yeah, wait, if this result holds.
What a beautifully played ball by Franco Varga. It was set up by a gorgeous pass from Metzinger. Tick tack, but no toe. Unfortunately for the Warhawks, it was a beautifully crafted run from the center to the right, back across the frame of goal, and it should be level 2-2.
Yeah, Franco Varga all alone there on that right side. Looked like he had a one-on-one matchup with Mark Weir there. Probably could have taken a shot. Decided to be a little unselfish. Dropped it off to Alan Harwell, who I can honestly say I didn't even see there. Harwell wide open. Probably could have settled it for a second and punched it in the back of the net instead.
Varga takes the shot there, and you're probably okay with that. When he first passed it, you were wondering where he was looking. And then Harwell's standing there all alone.
Yeah, and had Varga taken that shot, short of an amazing save by Mark Weir, we'd probably be looking at a 2-2 even match here.
Now we've got a foul call. Business again about to pick up here. That was the best chance of the second half. No doubt about it. For either team, really, the goal from Skyers was fantastic. But the execution was simply flawless on the build-up there for the Warhawks. Outside of the finish that was lacking from Harwell. Maybe another bit of magic here for the Wildcats on a counterattack.
Yeah, Goney
was Goney streaking through the middle. But we've got a foul called there.
Yeah, Goney was looking to take another shot at the goal. Not successful on that one.
Goney and this three guys up front for Bethel. Goney, Skyers, and Errol Reed. About as tough as any trio you're going to find up top in this tournament or in the conference all season. This one kicked out of touch. It'll be a throw-in for the Warhawks. B.J. Watson getting closer.
Yeah, Tevin Skyers looking to check back in for the Wildcats.
There's a hip check. to use a little hockey terminology. Right near the sideline, our staff photographer and noted Canadian Guy Schaefer approves of the terminology usage. And it sets up a free kick for the Warhawks.
Vladico.
Saw Vladico with a perfectly crafted corner kick earlier off that left foot. Let's see what he can deliver here. Heading toward the post. Ball is bobbled by Weir. Kind of a punch, really. It was tough to tell if it was a punch or a bobble, and we've got a Warhawk down in the box.
Yeah, not sure if he was punching that one out. He used two open hands. That's Grabelny down.
Grabelny down for the Warhawks.
Might have collided there with Weir on that punch. Weir trying to protect his box.
It was tough to see from our vantage point just how much of the ball Weir got right there.
Yeah, it looked to be.
Apparently enough just to trickle it out of danger. And unfortunately for AUM, the injury allows Bethel to bring this one back in and totally reset after what could have been a dangerous play. Under 19 minutes to determine our second finalist. The winner of this contest will meet the four seed, Martin Methodist, at 1:30 in Saturday's championship. Here's one, Errol Reed, a beautiful little bit of skill to dispossess a defender, but nothing comes of it. Winds are whipping here as we dip into the 9 o'clock hour Central Standard Time. We mentioned our production staff. Thanks to all the guys for making the magic happen today. Been out here since 8 a.m., some of them since 7.
Long day, but a lot of good soccer here today.
Been four great matches. And presumably two good finals coming up on Saturday. We'll have the call of both of those. SSAC Sports Network. This one, Jim Metzinger tried to lay it out. No one home. Here's Reed. Nice run here. I believe this is Goni on the far side. Stays on his feet. Goni, flag stays down. Goni, just wait.
Again, just wide for Goni. Hit pass.
It was a beautiful effort. Goni, oh, but the goal.
Hit pass went for another save there.
Coming out, number six.
Got caught on the ground.
Luke Seller.
Ball skirted right by him, right by the post.
So now,
could once again have been looking at a 3-1 lead for the Bethel Wildcats.
Bethel's had a couple of chances to make it 3-1. AUM had a gorgeous chance to make it 2-2.
Goni involved on both of those chances to go up 3-1.
Now a good run here. Wildcats looking to send this one forward. Beautiful clearance. At least temporarily by Watson. A flick on. Goni with a chance again. Back across. Skyers. This will be headed out to safety. And it looks like Kroger will check back in.
That was B.J. Watson on that clearance there to set up the corner for the Wildcats.
AUM checks back in the game.
And looks like it's going to be Kirshner.
Nicholas Poonel.
Clock is stopped with 16:14.
Kroger back in for Hunold.
Official signal to stop the clock for some reason. So this corner is whipped out.
Yep, not even put into play.
That's that wind coming in. If you don't angle it to the right just a little bit there, it's going to sail out of touch. Just like it did there. Goal kick coming up for hit pass. Time is starting to dwindle a little bit on the AUM Warhawks. But there has been some magic at this stadium over the years in postseason play for Auburn Montgomery. Will there be some magic in the dying moments tonight? It's 2-1. Bethel leading. The winner advancing to Saturday's final at 1:30. Automatic berth in the national tournament for the winner of that contest. This one played out. Weir's going to come sprawling out across the now, you presumably would think, dewy grass this evening. And this one will be punted into the night sky. Skyer is going to give chase. Hit pass will be there. We've seen this a couple of times. The wind will keepers involved. Especially one keeper downwind will be able to kick it all the way to the other box. Quick foul called as we dip under 15 minutes remaining now. This will be Vladico, the left-footed wizard, sending over this one. Sending this one in. Checking down the left flank. No one home. Good defense from the Wildcats. This one settled. Bethel on one perhaps. Flag stays down, but a touch. That will not lead to a goal-scoring chance. That one was a good look, but Rokiel just could not settle. Hit pass, boots it deep. Harwell is now switched to the right-hand side. Bottom of your screen here. Had it briefly. AUM's foul was, no, they called a throw-in before. Looked like that one was going to stay in play. Cheeky little through ball here. This one, it's an extra effort. The flag is down. The shot is up, and it's in. Hit pass had a hand on it, but it is Tevin Skyers. For the second time in the second half,
goal number eight,
with a goal, Wildcats, and this one
Bethel
may put a nail in the coffin for the Auburn Montgomery Warhawks.
Yeah, Tevin Skyers able to blast Bethel that one through, hit past his hands. Hit pass looked like he had a save there. Somehow the ball popped up over his head and just trickled into the goal.
That's normally a shot that hit pass collects. But this crowd is stunned here in Montgomery. The hometown Warhawks now trailing 3-1. And Bethel, they're 13 and a half minutes away from their first ever appearance in an SSAC final. Bethel may be the hottest team in the conference, entering on a five-match win streak. AUM struggling maybe to regain some composure offensively. You go back to that miss from Alan Harwell that would have gotten the Warhawks level. Beautiful run by Skyers, but he put too much on it. Skyers shed a defender. The tandem of Skyers and Reed are just so strong and physical up top for the Wildcats as a foul goes against Bethel. Two-goal deficit now for AUM. If there's going to be some magic for AUM at Emory Folmar, it needs to come here in a hurry. This one sent just outside the box. Now down over to Watson. Headed down. Kroger nearly had a hand on it, a foot on it. Now it comes all the way back. And Grabelny out of touch.
Checking in for AUM number 11, Nina Bozeson.
Nina Bozeson will check in.
To replace Baron Watson.
B.J. Watson will take a seat.
Coming in for Bethel, number 16, Luke Sellers.
And Luke Sellers has returned.
Replacing number 7, Errol Reed.
Errol Reed will take a seat. So Sellers, more of a defensive presence here. We may see Coach Melvin B. Long drop back and sink a little more defensively. Although it's a good-looking run here thus far.
You've got about four games.
From AUM. Does not lead to much. Skyers with a brace here in the second half has given the Wildcats a 3-1 lead. If First half goal from Errol Reed. And Bethel has outscored Auburn Montgomery 3-0 since the opening minute of this game. Remember, AUM scored just 22 seconds in. This one crossed in, knocked away. Looks like we'll have a corner kick coming up.
For that drop shoulder tackle that I heard about.
And this one sent across the frame of goal. 10:39 remaining. Both coaches now screaming directions. This is a critical juncture for AUM. They need to pluck a goal here if we're going to have any chance of clawing back in this one. Numbers going forward. The wind not allowing the deep ball. As Skyers now is tracking this one. Somehow he comes out of the pile with it and draws the foul. Ball bounced over the head of the defender. Skyers was able to hang with it and then forced the foul to be drawn. Skyers is going to return to the scene of the crime and receive a lecture from our official. And Coach Melvin Belon can taste a title game berth. If the Wildcats can hang on for the next 9:37, Bethel still attacking. That shot sails wide. Bethel now out shooting shots on goal, 6-3. Also enjoying the corner kick lead, 5-4. As we wind down now, under 9 minutes here in just a moment. That one by Keba Dimba. Back out to Reed, who just subbed out. Now he's back on. They send this one over. Sent in across the middle, blocked. Back out. Reed going to have a strike and a missile blocked away. Another one, but this one sails high.
Yeah, that first one from Reed was...
Hit pass may need to check his knuckles because on this type of night and with these type of conditions, that is an absolute missile fired off the right boot of Errol Reed.
Yeah, we talked about players shooting with the wind can just keep the ball low. It's going to be hard for a keeper to make any kind of save. Luckily, hit pass was standing in the path of the ball. Wasn't even able to collect it. He had to punch it away.
If hit pass wasn't 6'4", 190, he might have been blown to dust after that shot right there. Because Reed had some pace. And we think we know where we stand as far as Bethel's strategy here. They're still going to continue to push forward when they can. 2-2 in the regular season. Bethel wants a win here, and they want to win badly. They've got a two-goal lead, and they're 7.5 minutes away from punching their ticket.
Alan Harwell there kicked the ball off the back fence, deflected the hit pass so he could take that goal kick.
Take it rather quickly. AUM's got to string something together. Foul in the back of the legs here.
Smee Gonsalves challenging Varga there.
Bozen set to take this one. He's pushing numbers forward. Curling away from goal. And it's headed, and Weir will be able to easily pick that one up. Under 7 minutes now. Going back to that shot from Reed, that may be the hardest shot I think I've seen in 3 years of covering NAI soccer.
The way we saw
a blast at the girls' game today that AUM defender was able to stop. She had to check out of the game, McCardle. Otherwise, that would have been a candidate for a huge shot.
Saw a few crackers from one of the Red Hawks players, Jonathan Ramon, last year as well.
And Ramon and the Red Hawks awaiting the winner of this game. As it stands, it would be the Bethel Wildcats possibly rallying for a victory here. 6.5 minutes.
And either way, whichever way this result ends up, Martin Methodist is going to be faced with either a new rivalry or an old rivalry, as Bethel and Martin Methodist were both members of the Trans-South Conference. If the Wildcats are able to advance to the championship game, it'll be the first meeting in a tournament conference championship between the Wildcats and the Redhawks since the 2011-2012 Trans-South Conference Championship, where Bethel was able to escape with a 4-2 victory over the Redhawks.
Would be huge, no doubt. And right now, that's what we're faced with. Good turn by here. Ball stays with the Wildcats. There's Goni, who was voted the Freshman of the Year at our awards. Speaking of awards, worth noting, AUM has been without Offensive Player of the Year, Yannick Fallick, who had the opening assist. He left early in the first half and has yet to return. But the second half has been all Wildcats. Well, a good little run here, but too much on it right there from Franco Varga.
Yeah, somehow Orr was able to keep that ball in. Looked like he stopped it with his foot right on the line. Referee said play on.
Good looking ball right here by Reed. Drops it back.
It was Goni again.
Goni over to Demba. This is a shot sailing wide. And Coach B hands on his head. Thought his team had a fourth goal right there. Demba went with the left. Tried to go near post. An extremely difficult shot to pull off. And it clangs into the side netting.
It was all him and hit pass there. It was a nifty move crossing over to his left side. Get an open shot at the net.
This one knocked out. And now Bethel will make a substitution. Clock will stop with 3:50. Linsworth Daly, featured heavily in the first half, will take a seat.
Replacing Samuel Goni.
Yeah, Samuel Goni coming off.
This one played in now. Good little 1-2. They find Reed. Reed sitting on a goal. He bags another. It's a brace for Errol Reed. And the Bethel Wildcats have officially it to Saturday's final.
Keba Demba there.
Keba Demba to Errol Reed for the second time tonight.
With some fancy footwork to take a shot. But he had a teammate wide open. Pass it off to Errol Reed. Errol Reed hammers it into the back of the net.
And Reed, remind you, sitting on a yellow card. He could have possibly let his emotions get the best of him in the first half. Instead, he kept him in check, and he has delivered an emphatic performance here tonight. It's 4-1. The Bethel Wildcats, and we've got a card coming.
He's going to give that to head coach for AUM, Wolf Koch. Not really sure what happened there. Down 4-1 on what looked like a great offensive goal scored. Not really anything that led to it.
Tough for us to see from our vantage point, but a yellow card served to the AUM head coach. Flag stays down here, AUM with the chance. It'll be a corner kick. Errol Reed and Tevin Skyers have combined for 4 goals, and Bethel has rattled off what is going to be a big win. Bethel, the higher-seeded team, and they're the hottest team in the conference entering this tournament. Here's another, a chance for a hat trick. Reed can't get onto it. But coming into this contest, Hunter, we knew that AUM and Bethel would have a chance to produce some fireworks, and it's been the offense of the Wildcats that has produced the action here tonight. Ticking under 2.5 minutes now. AUM with just one senior SSAC's team. Quite a bit of youthfulness as there's a collision. Looked like a clean tackle from our vantage point.
Yeah, I think it was a clean tackle. They're just going to signal in.
Grant Duke checks
a little bit of an admonishment there.
Grant Duke's coming in for the Warhawks. He's going to replace Grabelny. Weren't quite sure if the referee was waving the defender to come over and speak to him or if he was issuing the reserve to come in.
Tough to determine there. Here's Reed with it. The counterattack and the big physical attacking presence of the Wildcats has been more than impressive for Bethel. Errol Reed, Jamaican native. Tevin Skyers, Jamaican native. The two juniors have linked quite well tonight. Keba Dimba to the mix. Not bad. The freshman from Tyler, Texas, fitting right in with this Bethel Wildcat squad as we are a minute and 5 seconds remaining from match day number two being in the books here in this SSAC Men's Soccer Championship.
Bethel looking to renew that rivalry, as we mentioned, with Martin Methodist.
It will be Bethel and Martin Methodist on Saturday, our women's final. Set to be a good one, as well as Mobile and William Carey will get it on. William Carey suffered exactly one loss in the regular season. Who was that loss to? University of Mobile.
Mobile Rams.
Down to 30 seconds now here.
And you'd probably think that Bethel Wildcats and Martin Methodist Redhawks are going to be looking for a national championship berth.
Right, there will be no automatic berth, you would assume, for the loser of that contest. So it'll be all the chips on the table, so to speak, when those two age-old rivals get it on Saturday.
Clock is counting down.
One final shot from Skyers. That draws a save.
They were looking to add on to this 4-1 lead here.
4-1, an emphatic come-from-behind victory for the Wildcats of Bethel University. Four goals consecutively. They come storming back. Two from Kevin Skyers and two from Errol Reed. Kevin Dimba with a pair of us. Keba Dimba with two assists. A fantastic performance here in Montgomery against the hometown Warhawks. Hunter, it's been a pleasure this afternoon. We've had four fantastic tests, and we'll have two good ones coming for you guys on Tuesday again. Our final score tonight, it's 4-1. Before we go, we want to thank Commissioner Hall and all the gang for hanging with us today down here. We also, of course, want to give a major shout-out to our camera guys and our producer and staff for braving the elements all afternoon. Spencer, Lane, and Phil. Also, Scott Cheney, our main producer here, and our staff photographer, Mr. Guy Schaefer. For Sam Niehans and all the rest of all the Southern States Athletic Conference staff, for Hunter Lee, for Tim Wilson, and for all of you listeners, thank you for tuning in. This is the end of match day number two, the championship round coming your way on Saturday. We'll have the call beginning at 11 a.m. here on SSAC Sports Network. Good night from Montgomery.